The AFL is defending its drugs policy after a spike in the number of players testing positive. Rory McLaren joins us live with more details. Rory, how many footballers are involved?
Hermione, 26 AFL players tested positive to using illicit drugs last year. Now that compares with just 6 in 2011. So of those 26 players, 2 have recorded their second strike under the AFL's at times controversial 3 strikes policy. But on top of the positive tests, as many as 26 more players have come forward to AFL medical staff and doctors to admit they've used illicit drugs. So therefore, the real number of confirmed cases of illicit drug use in the AFL is somewhere closer to 50. So that's a massive spike. And despite that, the AFL is standing by its results.
You may think that a significant increase is devastating. From our perspective, it means we've identified more people that we can shift their behaviours.
Hermione, the AFL is already making moves to tighten its illicit drugs policy. The so-called self-report loophole has been closed, and the league is also committed to undertaking more hair testing during the what they call the at-danger off-season period.
OK, Rory McLaren, thank you. Police say they could be closing in on Victoria's most wanted man who's been on the run for 3 years. They believe convicted murderer Graham Potter may have been living around Cobram near the New South Wales border.
We believe Potter camps out in camping sites and works as a fruit picker or a labourer, and that's what we believe he may be doing in this particular area.
Potter is wanted on conspiracy to murder and drugs charges. Police will investigate allegations the Labor Party tried to bribe MP Craig Thompson not to stand as an independent in the coming election. Mr Thompson claims he was offered a lucrative deal by the New South Wales Labor Party President Sam Dastyari.
He then said, why would you do that if it's about issues of redundancy? You have the same entitlements if you are beaten in a pre-selection for a party as you do if you stand for the election.
Mr Dastyari denies any such offer was made. Rugby league legend Glenn Lazarus has joined Clive Palmer's political party. The 47-year-old will lead the Queensland Senate ticket for the Palmer United Party.
As you all know, I've put on the green and gold for this country, and I know what it's like to represent Australia. I can't stand by and see Australia destroyed.
He'll also be joined by former A-League player Scott Higgins. James Packer has chosen the design for his planned casino and hotel in Sydney. A British firm won a competition to build the $1.5 billion development at Barangaroo. Designers say it's inspired by 3 twisting petals.
I think that the design that we've put forward, I hope people like. I think we're really proud of it.
The development is yet to be approved by the state government. And Sound of Music star Dame Julie Andrews is about to start her first ever tour of Australia. The 77-year-old's new show kicks off in Brisbane this weekend before heading to Perth.
What took you so long? It's really a sort of intimate conversation, really. It's about my life and how I began and how I toured. I'm going to be showing a lot of footage of stuff that perhaps people haven't seen.
But there'll be no singing after an operation damaged Dame Julie's famous vocal cords. She now writes children's books with her daughter. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 20 degrees in Townsville, 12 in Brisbane, 15 degrees in Sydney, 12 in Melbourne and Adelaide, 19 degrees in Perth.